Hey everyone, today we're going to learn how to send a score from a custom game inside of Storyline to any learning management system. Let's go ahead and get started. If you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all my different blog posts, all my previous blog posts that I have. You can check out different templates, and we're going to be working with one of those templates today, which will be the quiz time template. You can also check out different courses on Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom Scorm, and HTML5 Video. I've been asked this a lot throughout my time teaching Storyline is how do I send over the quiz score if I've created a game inside of Articulate Storyline and I wanted to send over the quiz score, how do I do that? Unfortunately, it does take some JavaScript and I'm going to provide you the JavaScript down below. You can check that out below the video, but I'm also going to walk you through how to actually take that JavaScript and what it means and how to apply it to your game. We're going to walk through this quiz time game and I'm going to show you how to do it in here. And when you download the template, the code is in there automatically as well. So keep that in mind. But we're going to take that and we're going to walk through it and explain that. So let's go ahead. And if you haven't already, if you want to follow along, make sure that you download the quiz time template. And once you download the quiz time template, this is what you'll see. You can see it's just a simple Jeopardy style game. So you have different rows and different columns and everything like that. This is free. I'm not charging anything for this template. So you can go ahead and just use this how you want. And if you wanted to customize this game to your heart's content, you can. All right, I'm going to go into here in my Articulate Storyline, and I'm going to go into the final feedback layer. Now, if you've downloaded it, you'll see the code, so keep that in mind. If you are working with a different game, you'll have to keep track of the score somehow. I have a couple different variables that are important here. You can see that the first variable is row one, and that's what displays for the row one. And whenever somebody gets a row one question correct, that's how many points get added to their score here. I also have a row two, I have a row three, and I have an overall score. Now those rows, when somebody gets it correct, adds to the overall score. What's important to note here, I'm gonna go back to the game board. What's important to note is how many points are actually total. How many points you can get if I got every single thing correct. In my case, it's 2,700 points because we have to figure out the percentage before we send this over to a learning management system. And in order to do this, we have to do a SCORM command. So we're gonna walk through what that is here. Going back to the top layer, I'm gonna go into this finish game. I want the score to be sent over to the learning management system as soon as the game actually, or when they click on the finish game button here. So let's go ahead and add a JavaScript trigger. I'm gonna come up to my triggers over on the right-hand side, and then I'm going to add this custom JavaScript trigger. It's already selected for me because the last trigger that I did was a JavaScript one, but if you don't see this execute JavaScript, you can just scroll down to execute JavaScript. I'm gonna go ahead and click on this JavaScript window here, and we're gonna type in a couple things. We need to establish a couple different variables so we can talk to the player, the Storyline player. That way we can grab what the score is, the final score, because we're keeping track of it already within our game. And then we're gonna talk to the window, the LMS window, the parent. And basically that's how you then say, hey, LMS, we're sending you over a score. So we're gonna establish those in a couple different variables so we can then simplify the code later on. So let's go ahead and write those variables right now. Now, the way that you write a variable in JavaScript is you type in let. You could also type in var. Most commonly now you type in let. We're gonna say let player equal and then get player. So capital G. With a JavaScript, everything has to be capitalized in the same way that you see here. So make sure that you do that as you're following along. And not capital L, but we're going to say let player equal get player, and then open close parentheses and end that with a semicolon. So we're getting the Storyline player, and we're storing that reference, the get player, in a variable called player. That way, from there on, if we wanted to talk about the Storyline player, we don't have to type in get player, we just simply type in player. And then it will reference the Storyline player. So it's just a shortcut way of doing that. The other variable that we need is score. We need to grab the score of the storyline score that we've saved in here. Now you need to talk to the player to be able to do this, and then you need to be able basically go in and grab the score, and you need to know what the variable name was. And I named it simply just score, all lowercase and everything. We're gonna go ahead and say player.getVar, and then open close parentheses. You can end that with a semicolon, but inside of here, we need to grab the variable name. Now you do this inside of quotes. And so I'm gonna say quotes, and then I'm gonna type in the name of the variable. That's how I then grab the score. Whatever the content, whatever the number is inside of that score, I'm gonna grab that and I'm gonna store it inside of this variable here called score, which is named the same thing, but it's kind of a different layer. I'm grabbing the content inside of storyline and I'm placing it here so I can then work with it inside of this JavaScript, this little window here. Again, might be a little bit confusing if we name the same thing, but we're just gonna do this just for this purpose. The let score get player, oh, and I said get car instead of get var. You do have to have that spelled the same. And then I'm gonna say let's percentage score or score percents. Let's just name it that and then equals. And then we're going to calculate because the score total could give us a number of 2,700. When you're passing over to a learning management system, you're going to be passing over a percentage. And so we need to figure out the percentage based on the total that a person could get. And that's what this score percentage or score perc is going to hold for us. But we need to do some math here. And it's just simple math. Don't worry, I don't like math either. But if I'm gonna come in here and I'm gonna say in parentheses, I'm gonna take the score that we just grabbed from the storyline player, and I'm gonna go ahead and divide that by 2,700. 2,700 is the maximum number of points that the person can get. And I just basically added up 100, 100, 100, 300, 300, 300, 500, 500, 500, because those are the points in each of those rows and columns. That's 2,700. Now, that's gonna give us a point something number. Now, I need to times that by 100 to grab the percentage. So I'm gonna go ahead and just times that. So I'll do an asterisk times by 100. Now that is going to give us our percentage. So we've figured out the calculation, we know what the percentage is, and now we can pass it over to the learning management system. Everything we've done up to this point is just talking to the storyline player. We got the storyline player, we got the score from the storyline course, and now we need to talk to the LMS. We need to create one more variable, and I'm gonna say let's, and that is going to be lmsAPI. I just capitalize API, but as long as it's consistent, just keep that in mind. We're gonna say window.parent. This is just a shorter way of saying talking to the LMS, because the LMS, when the course is inside of there, the course itself is actually kind of contained within different windows. It has the overall window, and then it has different windows below it. Now, we need to talk to the parents, and that's how we talk to the LMS. We need to say, hey, LMS parents, or the window, the parent window, we're gonna pass over a score. The way that we pass over the score is by simply doing lmsAPI.SetScore. Inside of these parentheses, we're gonna pass over three numbers. The first number is the percentage that the learner got. The second number is the maximum number that the learner can get. And then the third number is the minimum number. The LMS needs to know, okay, what's the maximum somebody can get in this quiz? What is the minimum somebody can get in this quiz? And then what did they actually get? And so those are the three numbers. Again, the first number is what did they get? Second number is what is the maximum? The third number is what is the minimum? So usually the maximum would be 100 and the minimum would be 0. So keep that in mind. But you just still have to pass over those numbers. So we already figured out what the learner got because that is our LMS, our score percentage. So we're gonna pass that over as the first thing. So really all I have to do is copy this variable and paste that inside of here as the first number. The second number, like I mentioned, is the maximum. And then the third number is the minimum. So that is all that I have to do in order to pass over the percentage. I have to go figure out or go grab what the score was inside of the game. I then have to figure out what the percentage is of that game. And then I just pass it over to the learning management system. Let's go ahead and click OK here. And I'm gonna click OK. and that will happen as soon as the learner clicks the button. Now notice that I have when the timeline starts, the course will count as complete. It's gonna pass over a completion as soon as it comes to this window. We need to do one more thing. I wanna close the window as soon as they click on that button. So we're gonna add one more trigger and we're gonna exit the course. That's the trigger that we're looking for, is exit course. So I'm gonna scroll down here. There it is, exit course, and then click OK. So it's gonna pass over the percentage and then it's gonna close the window after that. We're ready to go here. We don't really need to do anything else. So I'm gonna come into my home tab and I'm gonna go ahead and publish. And we're gonna publish to Scorm 2004. Now, the way that Scorm 2000 or Scorm 1.2 works is it may be slightly different, but Scorm 2004 is of Scorm, the latest version. So we're gonna go ahead and you can click on reporting and tracking. This will work in all the different editions. I'm gonna do fourth edition here. And then I'm gonna publish this to my desktop and hit publish. Depending on the size of your course or your game, it's gonna take a little while to do, but as soon as it's done, you then have a Scorm package you can upload. Now I am uploading and testing this to Scorm Cloud, that you can sign up for a free account at cloud.scorm.com and you can upload it. I always test my Scorm stuff here before I pass it over to my learning management system admin, just so I know that everything is working inside of here. And if it's working inside of here, it should be working inside of your LMS. So it's now done publishing. I'm gonna go ahead and click on zip here. It's gonna create a zip for me on my desktop. And now I can come into Scorm Cloud and I can upload this Scorm package. I'm gonna click on Browse, I'm gonna click on Quiz Time here, click Upload and click on Import. If it works here, it should work on your LMS as well. So just make sure that your LMS can handle Scorm 2004, which most of them should be able to. I know some of them prefer Scorm 1.2 and the command may be slightly different with 1.2, but I'm gonna click on Launch and then I'm going to click on Launch here. There is my quiz time game. I'm gonna click on start and let's click on all these different options. I know that in my template, all the correct answers are option A for now. So you need to switch that over when you're using this template, but I'm just gonna get some of them right. I'll get some of them wrong as well, just so we don't get like a full percentage here. And then I'm going to see what score has passed over. Okay, looks like we got 1900. So 1900 out of 2700 possible. And so it's going to figure out the percentage as soon as I click on the game, and it's going to pass that over to the learning management system as my score. So instead of using a quiz, you can create a game like this, and then you can go ahead and pass the score of the game to the learning management system as well. I'm gonna click on finish game. It's gonna close the window, and there it is. I scored a 70%. Just that little code, which you can technically, if you don't know how to type that or what JavaScript to type, you can just copy the code below the video, this code right here, and then you could just change out whatever score variable that you're using, change that out, and with whatever variable that you're using to keep track the same name, just make sure that it's, you know, have it as the capital as well. That needs to be the same as well. So if you just do that alone, it's going to pass over the score to the learning management system. So this simple little code allows you to track any game as a quiz instead of having to use a quiz inside of your Storyline course. Again, hopefully that was helpful for you. If you have any questions or if you want to see anything else, go ahead and go to my YouTube channel and comment down below. What else do you want to see? What other Scorm stuff? Do you want to track a video when a video completion happens inside of Scorm? I can do a video like that. So if you want to learn more about that, let me know. Now, if you want to also check out my previous blog post, you can check out previous blog posts at learningdojo.ninja and you can click on blog up here. You can download that templates and another memory game templates on my website as well. You can also get full courses if you're new to Articulate Storyline, or if you want to learn about Adobe Captivate or XAPI Fundamentals or Articulate Rise, Custom Scorm or HTML5 video, you can do that on my website as well. Thanks for tuning in and I'll see you next time.